Last few lectures we have seen the conditional statements that we call as an if and else. We check, or we have seen how we are going to check different conditions with the help of the operators, like we have used relational operators in terms of conditional statements. We have used logical and logical OR operators. We have used different kinds of the arithmetic operators as well for checking the conditions. Today we are going to use, we are going to deliberate the concept about the loops. I am taking an example first, why we need loops. Let's say stdio.h. Second one, hash include conio.h. And then after, we have an entry point, which is main, and after that, say for example, we need to print hello 10 times. So one way is to printf hello like this 10 times, is it? Like this, control C and control V. These are the printf that we are going to use for 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, 9, 10. And what we are going to use, we say that we are going to print, this particular hello 10 times. If we are going to compile this program, so it will save us, loop.c. And if we are going to execute, compile this, so, okay, no error, no warnings, and run, it will show us hello 10 times. And if we are putting \n in front of this hello, \n is meant for new line, is it? That means every line will be printed in the new line. So if we are going to execute this compile, okay, no error, no warning, run. That means we are printing hello 10 times, but this is easy for say 10 particular hellos. Let's assume I am giving you an assignment that you need to print 1000 times hello. That means you need to write down printf 1000 times. So instead of writing the repeated, as you can see, we are repeating the code again and again. We are repeating the code, printf, 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 again and again we are printing the same thing. What C provides us, that it tells the compiler, or it gives us the provision, that instead of printing the things again and again, it makes our code very huge. That means if we are going to print hello 1000 times, we are going to have 1000 lines of the code. But what they decided to introduce a loop. Loop means executing throughout itself. So instead of writing down the 1000 lines of the code, what we are going to use, the loops. Loop means repeating it again and again in terms of itself. When we talk about the loops, that repeating again and again in terms of itself, that means we should have some mechanism in terms of C. Is it? Or repeating the same contents again and again up to the a certain condition which becomes false. When we are going to execute this particular and hello should be printed 1000 times, it means that we should have some mechanism which will at least give us the provision that within the 4 or 5 lines our 1000 lines should get executed. And in order to do the same, we introduce the loops. C provides us three types of the loops. One is the for loop, second one is the while loop, and third one is the do while loop. So today we are going to discuss the first one, that is the for loop. What for loop says, the general syntax of for loop. So the general syntax of our for loop is like this. We have a keyword for, which is used for defining the for loop, and we have three sections. First one we call as an initialization / declaration section. Then semicolon. You should keep in the mind that your for loop sections are being delimited as with the help of the semicolon, or separated with the help of the semicolon. That means initialization or declaration section. Second one will be the conditional section. Condition section. And third one will be increment / decrement section. And then after, we will have the body of for. Is it? Now you should keep in the mind that for loop has three parts. One is the initialization and declaration section. Second one is the condition section. Third one is the decrement or increment section. You should keep in the mind the second point, that this section, initialization and declaration section, is being invoked only once at the entry of the for loop. Ye yaad rakhna ki ye jab entry karta hai for loop mein, ye initialization aur declaration section khali usi time pe invoke hota hai. Aur ye do sections bar bar invoke hote rehte hain. Increment decrement section and conditions. Let us take one example that we have earlier seen, that printing 1000 times or 100 times hello. See, we will see that int limit. हमने एक लिमिट लिया. लिमिट इसलिए लिया कि ताकि हम यूजर को बताएंगे कि कितने हेलो आपको प्रिंट. ठीक है, हम बताएंगे ऐसे प्रिंट एफ हाउ मेनी हेलोज टू बी प्रिंटेड. अब हमने यूजर को बताया कितनी हेलोज हमने प्रिंट करने हैं, तो हम क्या करेंगे, स्कैन अप करेंगे, क्योंकि यूजर से ले रहे हैं. वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द परसेंट डी बिकॉज इट्स ऑफ लिमिट इज ऑफ परसेंट इंटीजर टाइप. सो वी आर गोइंग टू यूज परसेंट डी प्लेस होल्डर एंड एम परसेंट ऑफ एल आई एम आई टी. दैट मीन्स वट एवर यू आर गोइंग टू राइट ऑन द कंसोल, सेव इट एट द एड्रेस ऑफ लिमिट. एंड आफ्टर दैट, अगर हमें वैसे ही करना होता तो 1000 टाइम्स प्रिंट एफ लिखना हो, या जो भी लिमिट होगा हमारे, हम क्या करेंगे, हम ऐसे लिखेंगे. फॉर हमें एक वेरिएबल बनाना पड़ता है जिसको हम काउंटर वेरिएबल भी बताते हैं. हम बताते हैं ऐसे, हमेशा फॉर लूप एवरी टाइम, इट्स नॉट मैंडेटरी बट स्टैंडर्ड इज, एवरी टाइम यू शुड स्टार्ट योर फॉर लूप फ्रॉम जीरो इंडेक्स. That means zero, indexing zero से start होनी चाहिए. So for I equivalent to zero, it's not mandatory, however, but we can start from one as well. There is no limitation for that, but it's the standard. There is difference between the standard and the rule. Standard means we should wear formals in the college. Is it? But somehow some people wear jeans in the college. Is it? This is standard. We should follow the standards. We should wear the formals. But it's not mandatory in the college as of now. It's not mandatory in the college that we should not wear jeans. Our teachers can wear jeans as well as formal. But it's a standard that the teachers should wear formals. Similarly, the standard is that your variables, your counter variables, should start from zero, or it should be initialized to zero. But it's not mandatory. Depending upon your logic, you can start from anywhere. So I am going to start from one. I equivalent to one. that means the initialization section, I less than limit or less than or equivalent to limit, and I plus plus. This is after that, this is the block of the print. We are going to use printf hello backslash backslash n हमने इसलिए रखा ताकि ये एक एक लाइन करके नीचे आ जाए. ठीक है, printf we are going to compile it, compile, no error, no warnings, and we are going to run. So we are going to, we see that kindly print 5 hellos for we people. 5 hellos, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. ठीक है ना. If we are going to print run 1000, so it will print 1000 that hellos for we people. If we are going to print, say, execute, run, say 50 or 30 print hello. So that means we are going to print it again depending upon the we are looping it. Similarly, it says that we are looping. Instead of 30 or 1000 statements, we are just printing, we are just executing two statements. Let me take it more frequently like this. Let me demonstrate it like this. Let me open the word. Okay, let me open the word and let me show you. See, we are printing like this, int limit. फिर हम बताते हैं यूजर को कि लिमिट का एक वैल्यू दे दो. फॉर एग्जांपल लिमिट हमने लिया है 10. जो लिमिट का वैल्यू हमने लिया था वो 10 लिया था. सो वी हैव टेकन लिमिट एज 10 एंड वी हैव टेकन वन मोर वेरिएबल इंट आई इक्विवेलेंट इज इट. और लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस टेबल लाइक दिस सो दैट इट विल बी मोर. So let me introduce initial value of I. Is it new value of I? Condition क्या है हमारी? I less than or equivalent to limit. ठीक है ना. Then print statements and then increment increment. Is it okay? That means we are going to have this kind of the table. Delete call. Now let's make it bold. So initial value of I was equivalent to 1. New value of I is also equivalent to 1. Is it? Is 1 less than or equivalent to 10, because we have chosen the limit as 10. So is I 1 less than or equivalent to true? The condition is evaluated as true because 1 is less than or equivalent to 10. So what we are going to print? We are going to print hello statements, just as we have seen, because after the statement, after the condition is becomes true, it prints the statement first and then increments or decrements the variable. Though that means if I is equivalent to 1, I less than or equivalent to limit, that means I less than or equivalent in this condition, in this particular topic, we are in this particular example, we are telling that a limit is equivalent to 10. So 1 less than or equivalent to 10, condition is true. So we are going to print hello. Again, it's going to say for increment, because after that increment will be, that means it's actually I plus plus. So increment I by 1. So I will become 1 plus 1, because previous value of I was 1, so it is 2. So new value, initial value was always 1, so we are not going to change it, but the new value of I is equivalent to 2. So 2 less than or equivalent to 10, what is condition? It's again true, because 2 is always less than or equivalent to 10. So we are going to print again hello, and we are going to increment it. I will become now 2 plus 1, which is equivalent to 3. So 3 new value and 3 less than or equivalent to 10, condition is evaluated as true, is it? So we are going to print hello. Now again I will be incremented by 1, that means 3 plus 1, it will be equivalent to 4. So 4 new value of I will be equivalent to 4, 4 less than or equivalent to 10, so condition is true, and we are going to print hello. I will be incremented by 1, it will become 4 plus 1, so it will become 5. So new value of I is equivalent to 5, and we are again checking the condition, 5 less than or equivalent to 10, again condition is true, and we are going to print hello. Now again increment I by 1, I will be equivalent to now 5 plus 1, it will be equivalent to 6, and new value of I will be equivalent to 6, again we are going to check, because it's again looping in terms of itself. So 6 less than or equivalent to 10, condition is true. So whenever condition is true, so what we are going to use, condition is true, so we are going to print hello. I will be incremented by 1, 6 plus 1, it will be equivalent to 7. So 7 less than or equivalent to 10, so condition is again true, printf hello. I will be again incremented by 10, that means 7 plus 1, it will become 8. New value of I will become 8, 8 less than or equivalent to 10, condition is true, so it will print hello. New value of I will become 8 plus 1, which is equivalent to 9, so new value will become 9, 9 less than or equivalent to 10, so it will become true, so hello will get printed. Now I will become 9 plus 1, because 9 was the value, current value, plus 1 equivalent to 10. Now see, 10 is 10 less than or equivalent to 10? Obviously 10 is not less than, but 10 is equivalent to 10, so it will be evaluated as true, so it is going to print help. So I will again increment by 1, I will become 10 plus 1, it will become 11. So new value of I will become 11, and here 11 less than or equivalent to 10. When we reach this particular point, 11 less than or equivalent to 10, condition will be evaluated as false, and when condition will be evaluated as false, it will never go inside of that particular block. That means ye wala jo hai, jab hum इस कंडीशन को, जब ये कंडीशन हमारी फॉल्स बन जाती है, तो हम इसके अंदर कभी नहीं जा सकते. We are going to exit from that particular. तो हमारे पास कितने आ गए? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That means we have printed 10 hellos with the help of simple two particular statements. But with the help of the for Hope this example gives you a little bit idea about for loop. In tomorrow's lecture, we are going to see the very next rather few examples related to for loop as well. Thank you very much.